bad, but they were stronger militarily. And we see this trend all over again. لا يغرنك تقلب الذين كفروا في البلاد متاع قليل. Don't be fooled by the power of the unbelievers on earth. Short living does not last. متاع قليل. Now, understanding this on one hand, let us understand the Islamic civilization. See, every civilization in the world went through this trend. Gradual growth, peaks, challenged by an outside power, collapses very quickly. This is repeated in history. Except Islam. That is the only civilization that did not go through this. And let me show you quickly the movement of the Islamic civilization. Of course, this would need a very long lesson, but I will summarize it in short words. Islam started in Mecca. From a civilization point of view, civilization starts when you have a country to rule. Without a country, without land that you rule, you don't have really a full civilization. You might have a theory, a methodology, an ideology, but not a full civilization until you establish it on land. So the first 13 years of Islam in Mecca were the development of the ideology, the faith, the morals for the Muslims. And that is why you see in the first 13 years of Islam there was no political system, social system, judiciary system. There was nothing. Even in worship, that was, there was only salah, prayers. يعني صيام, زكاة, حج, all came in Medina. It was an establishment of the ideology and the morals. إيمان وأخلاق. That was Mecca. So, with Hijra, the Islamic civilization started. And رحم الله عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه ومن معه for the right choice of Hijra as the start of the Islamic calendar. Because it was the start of civilization for Islam. Also, it was the start of a state. Everything changed after that. Brothers and sisters, even the Quran changed. When you read Surah Makkiyah, the style is different from the Surah Madaniyah. Even the Quran changed with this move from Mecca to Medina. So that was the year zero. That's where we started. How large was the Islamic state? Oh, definitely smaller than Sydney. One very small town called Yathrib, later on named Al-Madina Al-Munawwara, ala sakinha afdal as-salat wa at-taslim. Very small. We're not talking hundreds of thousands. Maximum estimation was about 30,000. A very small town. And that is counting the non-Muslims and counting the Jews, etc. That's all they had. And women and children, and I'm counting everyone. So, quickly moving through history. Year 2 of Hijra, the Battle of Badr. Just a small note on the Battle of Badr. I explained it in detail in my series album As-Sira An-Nabawiyya. But I will take only one comment. See, the Muslims in Badr were 314. The unbelievers were 950. بين التسعمائة والألف. 950. The number of horses with the kuffar was 200. Number of horses with the Muslims were only 2. So we're not talking we were larger in numbers, larger in powers, etc. It's very small. And the whole battle is a very small battle. You're talking 300 or so people meeting 950 people. What is this? According to any scale in the world, in the past or the present, this is a very small battle. Do you know, brothers and sisters, how long did the battle last? 2 hours. Not 2 days. Not 2 days. 2 hours. One of the kuffar who was not in the battle, who was not from Quraysh, was sitting on a hill when the battle happened. He started to watch, like a movie happening in front of him. So he was watching. He was not with the Muslims, he was not with Quraysh, he was just watching. His name was Ibn Asham. Suddenly, 2 hours later, the battle was over. And he was expecting, you know, a long movie, like an Indian movie or something. It was a very short documentary. So he said to himself, وَاللَّهِ مَا رَأَيْتُكَ الْيَوْمِ عَجَبًا فَرُّوا مِنْهُ كَالنِّسَاءِ. I have never seen a surprise like this in my life. They ran away like women. 5 years later, this man was visiting Medina. He was still not a Muslim. And the Prophet ﷺ saw him. He asked him, are you Ibn Asham? He said, yes. He said, didn't you watch the battle of Badr? He said, yes. He said, what did you say after the battle was over? He said, nothing. He said, didn't you say to yourself, وَاللَّهِ مَا رَأَيْتُكَ الْيَوْمِ عَجَبًا فَرُّوا مِنْهُ كَالنِّسَاءِ. I have never seen a surprise like this. They ran up from him like women. Ibn Asham said, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهِ مَا حَدَّثْتُ بِهَا أَحَدًا. He said الشهادتين and said, I have never spoken this to anyone. It's the prophethood. 70 unbelievers were killed and 70 were wounded. What is the 70? That's all. I mean, in bombs today, you see more people killed. 70 people. And this battle is the greatest battle of Islam. Why? Why is it the greatest battle of Islam? A small battle in numbers, very short in time, limited in place, did not conquer Mecca. Still it is the great. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, يوم الفرقان يوم التقى الجمعان. It's the division. It's the battle that divided truth from evil. We understand it by a comment of one young man in Medina. He was with the army, one of the Ansar. He was with the army. When they came back victorious, his family was congratulating him on winning in the battle. He said,